Hey Jackals, in this video I'll give you the full guide on how to make subtitles from video or audio completely for free. But you'll have to do them manually. Just joking. Kind of? You can do them automatically, but this will depend on the language spoken and how clearly the language is spoken. And you can also make automatic translations, but sometimes these are not good, so you have to fix them by hand. I'll also timestamp this video down below, so you can simply go to the subject that you want to see. Now let's get digital. Making subtitles can take a lot of time, and I did a video on how to make them using online services, but this time we won't be using those. What we need is Autosub. I'll leave a link to this version that I've used, but you can use any version that you want. You can do also a lot with Autosub, and you can see the usage down here, but I'll be just using the basic functions. So with Autosub, we'll be making automatic subtitles, but sometimes the result won't be that good. What we can also do with Autosub is take any spoken language in the video or the audio file and translate it to another language. And we can also do that with subtitles. Take a subtitle that has any language and translate it to another language. But depending on the source language, you'll probably have to make some fixes at the end. Is there a downside to Autosub? Besides the translations not being accurate, it can be a pain in the ass to install. Now if the audio is quiet, we can use something like DaVinci Resolve to boost the audio, and if you don't get any audio in DaVinci Resolve, we can use something like Handbrake. And lastly, we'll use Aegisub to make and fix subtitles. Now let's prepare the audio slash video file. In this case, I'll be using Handbrake and DaVinci Resolve, but you don't need these two, or at least you don't need the Handbrake. You can achieve the same result with ffmpeg, which is included in Autosub. So you can go to the Autosub section and then come back to the DaVinci Resolve section if you need to increase the audio volume. Now, if you're using DaVinci Resolve, just to show you what the issue is, if you're using DaVinci Resolve and you don't see any waveform, you can use Handbrake to do this, or ffmpeg. In Handbrake, simply take the file that you want to fix, drag it in, go to video, use frame FPS same as source, and use constant frame rate. You can decrease the quality of the video because you don't need it, then specify the path where you want this to be saved and encode it. Since we only need the audio, this should be done fast. So that is done, and now let's jump into DaVinci Resolve. In DaVinci Resolve, I'll use the file that we just made. So it is this one, put it in, and as you can see, it immediately showed the waveform. So we can now right click on it and normalize the audio level if you want, but we could also increase the volume gain or decrease it manually or adjust it in the inspector tab, or you can even go to the Fairlight page and boost the output level of the master volume. Then once you have that, you can go to the delivery page, then set the in and out point if you have multiple clips like I have, so I and O, so only this clip will be rendered out. In the video settings, uncheck export video. In the audio settings, choose wave, specify the file name and location, and add it to render queue, and then simply render this out. So this was the file that was just made, and it's a wave file. And if I put it inside here, we can compare the waveform, and as you can see, this one is a lot louder than this one, and that is because I've changed the decibels in the output of the master volume. And just so you know, having a clip with different volume levels, like in this two case, this tool will actually give different result when using Autosub, because the speech detection will be different. Now let's get to the main point of the video, which is Autosub. And first we'll do the installation, which can be a pain, so I suggest you use the instructions. If you use Linux, click on Ubuntu, but in this case, I'll choose Windows. At the beginning of the installation on Windows, you have a link, and it takes you here. What we'll want to do is click on Assets and download any of these two files. You can also download both of them and give them a try. In my case, they didn't work, so I had to do the installation manually, and I'll show you how to do that. It's been a while since I made the installation, so if I miss a step, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll try to help you out. So this section didn't work for me, so what I had to do is install Chocolaty. You can go to the website, click on install, and follow the instructions here. I won't go through this, but what you can also do is copy the whole command here. You can also click on this button, and you have to open it in CMD, which is command prompt. and not PowerShell. So if you right click on start, you can see PowerShell. This is not it. Click here, type in CMD for command prompt, and you can paste this inside. As you could see, when I pasted the command in with Ctrl V, the command ran, but because I already have Chocolate installed, it didn't install. So I can now close this. Then I also needed to install the build tools for Visual Studio 2019. This link will take you here. You can simply download it, but this download is big and it will take some time. Then once you have that installed, you can simply choose one of these three options. And I think I used the dev version, Autosub dev. Now how do you use these commands? Well, let's simply go to the C drive, hold shift, right click, and select open PowerShell. Then simply paste these lines in one by one. So this is the first one, this is the second one, third one, and the last one. Now I'll just show you how the copy looks like, but I won't be installing anything. So it's simply paste it in like that, press enter, and let the command finish. And do that for all four lines. I chose the dev version because I think it was the latest one, or at least this one worked for me and the alpha one didn't. So when I had everything installed, I still had some issues. I can't remember what exactly it was. Was it with build tools or something else? But I found this topic, and this link here takes you to here. Now I can't remember if I installed this one, but I do remember that I went just here to this and type in 11. Here it's Levenstein with an H, but I think in the PowerShell, when you actually run the autosub command, it was without an H. In my case, I installed this one, AMD 64 3.9 version, because I think this depends on the version of the Python that you have, Python 3.9, and you put this file inside here. And then when you have it inside here, you will run this command. Now the command will look like this. Just make sure that you actually have the same name as the file that you actually downloaded. Then copy everything and paste it inside the PowerShell, hit enter and wait for it to install. But if you do the installation with exactly this command, make sure that you're in the Python folder, hold shift, right click, open PowerShell here. As you can see, this now changes the path to Python, and paste the command here and wait for it to install. Now, if you've done the installation correctly, you can use the autosub command from anywhere on the system. So I'll open it in this folder, type in autosub, and this will give you a list of commands. And there's a lot of them. Now that you have autosub installed, you don't need to use Handbrake to get the audio file. You can use this command. So we'll use ffmpeg, rename the file to what the file actually is. So in my case, and this will not work, I'll just give you an example. So test with sub.mp4. So this will be the file name. You have to use parentheses if the file has spaces, otherwise you don't need them. If the file would be, for instance, named like that, then you don't need to use parentheses. So like that. And the sample mp3, this will be the output file. So we can name it output. And when I press enter, this should not work because I'm not in the correct location. Let's see. And as you can see, I'm not in the correct folder. So when you do this, you actually have to be in the folder that you have the video files in. And now when you paste in the command, I'll just copy this one. And this should now work. As you probably noticed, I didn't use mp4, but even if I fix this, it didn't work, and that's because I'm not in the actual location where these two files were located. So if I fix this and use mp4 here, this will make the audio file, and it's titled output mp3. I'll close this window now. So I'll enable the sound so you can hear it, so it actually works. Hey Jackals, do you want to know what's new in DaVinci Resolve 17.4 update? Yeah, if you do, go watch that video. So now when you have the audio file here, you can put it in DaVinci Resolve and maybe increase the volume or decrease it so that you can see what the difference is when you use it in Autosub. And now let's use this file in Autosub to make the subtitles. So let's see if this command works. What this will do is call the Autosub script. The input file will be output.mp3 because we're actually in this location. And the source language is English. And this will make English subtitles. Now, as you can see, it made the subtitles and it used Google Speech API. And if I open them, you can see that we have the timestamps and the text. But some of the timestamps don't have any text and we have to put it in manually. And for that, we'll use Aegisub. But before we do that, let me just show you a few of the other commands that you can use in Autosub. And let's see what's the accuracy of this sound detection. So I'll open this video and put in the subs. Want to know what's new in DaVinci Resolve 17.4 update? You do? I'll show you a few things that I like. Now let's get digital. As you can see, the latest update is actually 17.4.1. So that result was actually okay in my opinion. But if you use a language that is not English, like in this case, I'll use this one, which is Slovenian. And let's just fix that. So it's LSI, untitled wave. So it made the Slovenian subtitles, but I can tell you that they are not correct. So you'd have to fix them manually, like I did. But what you can also do is make a translation from this subtitle, which is Slovenian, and maybe make it English. And let's do that. Now, if you want to get an automatic translation from a spoken language like Slovenian to English, what you have to do is use this command, just like so. Otherwise, if you don't use both the minus S and minus SRC, this will not make a file. So when we now make the command and wait a little bit, you can see that we now have a file and it was made as untitled.en. As you can see, it automatically translated from Slovenian to English and we also have the subtitle timestamps. But admittedly, the translation is not accurate, so we would have to fix them using Aegisub. So if you look at the Autosub help, we can see that S is actually the speech language, SRC is source language, and D the destination language. If you want to know which languages you can use as a translation, you can use Autosub space minus LTC, and this will give you the language codes. You use these codes with SRC and D, but you need to use the double codes for the source and to get those. So the codes for the speech language, as you can see, is minus LSC. And this gives you the speech codes. So you have to type in this when you use the S and only use the single codes when you use the source and the destination. In this example, I only used MP4, MP3, SRT and WAV, but you can use a lot more file formats. So just take a look what those are. And before I forget, let me just show you how you can translate an existing subtitle to another language. In this case, I'll use this one, which is Slovenian. And I'll just use this text file without any audio. So this is how the command would look like. Just put in here the name of the file, source language, and the destination language. When you press enter, as you can see, this was immediately done. Now let's take a look if there is any differences. This is the new one. Open it in Notepad. And this is the old one, which was done using the audio. As you could see, the translation was the same, and that is because it used the same Google API. And speaking of APIs, you can use a couple of them, so you'll have to play around to see which one gives you the best result. And also, some of them are paid, so keep that in mind. But what you can also do to get a different result for the speech recognition and then for the translation is to increase the volume level and use that audio file to see what results you'll get. Now finally, let's take a look at the Aegisub. You'll want to put in the video file that you have. Simply move it, wait for it to load. Use the subtitle files that you created. I think it was this one. And if a video is already in and you know it's the one that you want, simply use no. So as you can see, while the translation was not perfect and I have to fill a few gaps, or maybe a lot, depending on the source language that you used, I have all of the time codes set for me. But if you need to split text up, let's say this one, I want to split it here. I could make a copy before or after, so maybe I'll insert this after. Grab this one here, click it, okay. And then this next one is this part, click okay. And now we can just type in the text. I actually don't know what I said, so maybe something like that. And if you need to split the line, you can use Shift Enter to split it like that. And to save it, simply use Control S and this will save it in the same file. Now in Aegisub, if you want to move down line by line and hear what was said and what the text is, simply press space.
Hey Jackals!
Then press Enter and press space again to play the new line.
Do you want to know what's new in DaVinci Resolve 17.4 update?
You do? Go watch that video. And that's where you can make automatic subtitles and translations, but this will depend on the source language that you use. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more video editing, DaVinci Resolve content and content like this. And hit the bell notification icon so you don't miss my next video. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital.